either make this succeed or not. And we appreciate the fact that you've already been trained, and we'd love for you to be able to, you know, there may be some questions that people will have later. So our next partner that we was very important was the National Truckers Against Trafficking. And we would like to recognize them and let them tell you a little bit about the national program and how they have spread this nationwide. So I'd like to introduce Ms. Kyla Lanier.
In January 2015, an RV pulled into a truck stop in Virginia. Police were quickly called to the scene. After they arrived and interviewed the occupants of the vehicle, the horrific story made headlines. A young woman, 20, had been kidnapped out of Iowa 2 weeks prior. She had been beaten, raped, her entire body burned with instruments heated on the RV stove, branded, and tortured. She was being sold by her traffickers, Laura Sorensen and Alder Hadza, through sex ads posted on Craigslist, where men were purchasing her and then coming to that RV to rape her. Doctors said that had that call not been made, she would have died within a few days from the malnutrition and torture she had been subjected to. That call was made by professional truck driver Kevin Kinnett, who recognized that something was off. Something was wrong, and instead of turning a blind eye, he picked up the phone. Today, that young woman calls her his guardian angel, her guardian angel. Kevin calls himself a trucker against trafficking. People ask us all the time, why truckers? And there's actually a lot of reasons why, but here's where we start. At any given time, there are more truck drivers on the road than there are law enforcement officers. They're already trained to be vigilant. They're the eyes and ears of our nation's highways. And they, along with truck stop employees, may intersect with trafficking victims in the normal course of their jobs. So trained, equipped, and empowered to recognize the signs of human trafficking, they will continue to save lives. While it is important for every member of our society to recognize the signs of human trafficking so that they can report it effectively, we also know that critical populations are always first to be called on to take a stand. Professional drivers are just one such critical population and are already working with law enforcement around the country to close loopholes to traffickers. Thus, we are honored to be a part of this first of its kind legislation that will ensure all CDLA holders state of Arkansas received this life-saving training. We thank Representative Douglas and Senator Collins Smith for their leadership in championing this bill. Our partners at the Arkansas Trucking Association, along with TAT, as well as the Arkansas Legislature, believe in the power of the trucking industry to make an impact in the crime of slavery. This law will stand as a model that other states will replicate, and we are excited to see the exponential effect that the actions today will have. When our eyes are open to the realities of human trafficking, we can't help but be spurred to action. The Arkansas trucking community, whether traveling within state borders or interstate, when educated on this issue, will continue to be an invaluable